Well, good morning, Newcastle. As we get ourselves kind of squared away here and start a busy Saturday morning, complete with all the weather you got to know. As wow, we've been up a little bit early. We got around and checked things out, and we're set to give you a lot of information on conditions, what to look for, and that type of stuff as we move forward. The train is on the tracks and Newswatch is straight ahead for you.
Broadcasting from the greatest castle in the world, in the County of Lawrence, NCTV 45.
Entrusting your loved one to a funeral director is a very personal and emotional decision. The funeral director you choose must understand the importance of the decision you have made. When you call the William and Roger DiCarbo Funeral Home, I recognize what a privilege it is to be chosen at your time of need. We will provide you and your family with the best service possible, with sincerity and compassion.
The William and Roger DiCarbo Funeral Home, family owned and operated since 1941.
If you're craving hot dogs and more, and you're in the area, then look no farther than Coney Island, downtown Newcastle on Kennedy Square.
For one great dining experience.
Bill's Bake Shop will make you happy. Owner Bill Cast and his staff keep the tradition going with all those bakery items you remember as a kid. Just to name a few, Bill makes cream sticks, cinnamon rolls, bear claws, cream horns, cannoli, cakes, pies, cookies, bread, pizza, and more. You can also buy homemade cavatelli and ravioli. Bill's Bake Shop, located 228 North Liberty Street in the Mahoningtown section of Newcastle, is open Tuesday through Saturday, 7 to 5, and Sunday, 7 to 2, closed Monday. Bill's, where smiles are everywhere. Call 724-654-4223.
Well, folks, we're back, and let's get to some conditions here that I guess can explain to you what's going on, and I'm going to get this out of the way right now. And here we go. Currently in Newcastle, and this is always measured at the airport, 26 degrees. There's a light snow flurry. I mean, you might get some snow, then a little freezing type precipitation, and then it moves on. Now, we were out and earlier today, okay, just to give you an idea. And I don't know if you've seen our Facebook post. So let me try to bring this up for you. And we'll give you some idea of what it looked like earlier on today. Now, this, as we were coming down the approaching Sunoco, and you can see off to the right it was icy, folks. Now, road crews have been out, and they've really been covering the area. But what you have on a lot of the roads is one lane, like the left-hand lane, is clear, and you'll see the right-hand lane is snow-covered. That still exists in what's kind of going on, as it's been a mixed bag as far as them being able to tell you just as things were happening. And I really don't like the way that is right there, and we'll put that down. And so with that, here is Cleveland radar, and then I'm going to go over some street conditions. You can see Pontiac, Michigan, and then we'll open this up bigger. Cleveland getting the rain right now. The snow just to the west of Youngstown. That part will be moving in shortly. We had the little break. Our break is just about over, as the snow flurries will get and continue. Now, with that being said, okay, and I'm gonna put this like that. With that being said, here is Pittsburgh radar. And we'll get it up. And it shows you quite clearly nothing in Pittsburgh right now, but it shows you where that line is. And you can see right underneath the G in Youngstown, that's us. To the west, the snow's starting to come down again in Boardman, Youngstown, Campfield. Now, if you go west of Mahoning County in Ohio, you get the rain. So that's where everything stands to the minute. So we're going to be taking that on in a short time as I hear some sirens going off. I can't tell you to slow down enough, because there are icy spots out there, and they're hidden, okay, because you're going to be dealing with a lot of black ice, hidden ice. It's 26. Just so you know, we'll keep you up to date. Now, let's talk about the roads. After having coffee and coming down Route 18 from the Shannon Township, the Shannon Township roads still snow covered. As we crossed into the city by Jameson UPMC, what we saw was Garfield clear. Sheridan was not. Okay, the street below Garfield, a little bit clear. The street below that, not. Okay, it's been hit or miss on the side streets. And when we were coming in earlier this morning, Arlington Avenue was clear. Washington Street was not. So you're dealing with this mixed bag, okay, of precipitation, and you're dealing with people trying to get the parking lots clean, the roads clean, sidewalks, and you've got more on the way. Now, the question is where's the temperature going to be when that gets in? We're going to keep you looking at that, and we'll update you as it comes up. For the most part, travel should be pretty good. If you're heading to Cleveland, you're going to be heading out of the snow and into the rain. If you're heading to Pittsburgh right this second, you've got a clear shot. Okay, if you're heading in and around the city, okay, and I include the townships in this, there are going to be some roads that are going to be outstanding. You're going to make the turn, and all of a sudden, the road's going to not be done. With the way the situation unfolded this morning, I don't believe it was possible for them to do everything at once, township, city, whoever. Okay, but the roads are in decent passable shape in the city. Be careful as you cross the city line going into Neshannock. It wasn't done a little bit ago. The lane heading north was, the lane heading south wasn't. But you can tell, and you can bet your bippy, that road crews are catching up right now. As I look at Fall Street, right outside us, a little slushy, a little wet, but not to the degree that it's impassable or unsafe. So you're going to really be okay doing whatever you have to do today. Allow yourself some more time, and understand that we got through a significant part of the winter here. We're at the middle of January. 6 weeks, we're in March. Significant part of the winter with really no inclement weather. Now, all that being said, let's get to some of the top stories today in Newcastle, PA. And this coming up this Saturday, so you're going to want to get your tickets. It is really huge. It is Super Brew 11 at the Crane Room. And, they're great up there. I absolutely love. I'm there a lot. They were a sponsor of ours for such a long time. Please check out the Crane Room. It's going to be something you're going to want to see. Now, with that, this from Chris Sonata. And, I was privy to a mailer that went out from the Republican Party, that's what it said on it, about Chris's record. Let's not start the campaign too early, folks. That's my only thing. Now, Chris Sonata, this in. 70,000 in state grants will expand computer science learning for Lawrence County students. Computer science will play an expanded role in the curriculum for Lawrence County students thanks to a $70,000 state grant under PA Smart Initiative. State Representative Chris Sonata, Democrat from Lawrence County, announced today that Sonata said the Neshannock Township and Union Area School District will receive $35,000 in PA Smart grants from the State Department of Education. This is an important place for computer science in our school's curriculum, right beside traditional basic subjects as math, science, engineering, said Sonata. In today's digital era, informational technology plays a critical role in every field. And thanks for that update, Chris. And we'll look to hear more from you. Now, they say this is a game changer, and you know, I am really big. I am sorry. I'm going to tell you, I am huge on family. Up there with the number one and number two areas in my world are church and family. And Notre Dame came out with a great t-shirt. We stand for the national anthem and kneel for the cross. And I thought that was excellent. Now, if that doesn't present itself or you have logistical problems, Epworth United Methodist Church, Saturday, February 8th. Good food, good friends, and a good time. Together we can make game changers. After school youth mentoring program. And we have a lot of people that need mentored. We here at NCTV 45 won an award, the mentoring award from Teal College. So I feel like I can say something about that. And they're inviting people to get this Newcastle community-based idea underway February 8th, 2020 at 4 p.m. Now, as we continue on with Newswatch, and before we get to sports, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank you, because you did it again. The first portion of the year, which goes from January 1st till now, the way they measure it. You told a friend and had a friend tell a friend about NCTV 45. And what is usually traditionally right after the holidays, a slow news time, you were able to up us 489%. Page likes up, post engagements up, post reach up. All because of you. And I humbly thank you for that warm and pleasant welcome that you always give me, NCTV 45, my son, my family. And we're happy to be operating right here in Lawrence County, Newcastle, the community television station that stretches from Elwood to Wilmington, the state line to Volant, and even beyond our borders, Mercer, Butler, and Beaver County. Thank you so much for chipping in and making us a part of your life. Now, if you just heard my phone go off, snow alert, okay, and they're talking about 8:21, okay, that snow will begin. We're going to keep an eye on that just to let you know what is happening as far as the snow goes. And here, let's go over a few things in sports. Trailblazers won 12, but the Mavericks got 120, and they won. It was the 76ers 100-89, and you know, I was watching that game. And do you know where I was watching that game? I was watching that game at Cedars. And do you know what they have? Now, I'm going to let you in on our huge, huge secret. They have a fish sandwich. It's the piece of fish is this big. And you can get it with coleslaw and macaroni and cheese, or you can get the sandwich. I got the sandwich, but next time I'm going for the dinner. It looked absolutely excellent. I wanted to tell you that. So, 76ers won. Well, my son, Angelo, his Spurs against the Hawks, 121 to 120. The Spurs fall by one. Tough break there. And as you get, we're going, excuse me, go to the Cedars Sports Corner and kind of catch you up on a lot more things going on. So hang in there. We'll be right back. Here's the Cedars Sports Corner.
The Cedars Restaurant in Newcastle wants you to indulge in the food from their pleasing menu. The Cedars features Mediterranean, pub food, Middle Eastern cuisine, and so much more. They're open every day 11 a.m. to 10 p.m. Call the Cedars on the east side at 827 Addis Street, Newcastle, 724-658-9543. That's 724-658-9543.
Hello and welcome once again to the Cedar Sports Corner Report, and let's get to NFL football. Sunday's matchup, Tennessee taking on Kansas City, 3:05, and Green Bay will be at San Francisco for the 6:40 matchup. Now, over in the NBA, Saturday, what are you looking at? Well, the Suns will be at Boston in the notable matchups, and Milwaukee will be at the Brooklyn Nets. That's 6 o'clock on NBA TV. Philadelphia will be at the New York Knicks. Detroit will be at the Atlanta Hawks. Cleveland, they'll be at the Chicago Bulls. And your late game, Portland will be at Oklahoma City. Over in the NHL, your games for Saturday, and full slate here, so we're going to take the ones that mean some. Washington at the New York Islanders. It will be the Blues against the Colorado Avalanche. Calgary, they'll be at Ottawa. Chicago will be at Toronto. The Los Angeles Kings will be at the Philadelphia Flyers. Buffalo will be at Nashville. And San Jose Sharks, they'll be at the Vancouver Canucks. Now, next up, college basketball, and, well, folks, we're in the full swing of those days, and let's go through this as we give you who's close to home and what's going on. The Pitt Panthers at home, they're against North Carolina. Penn State Nittany Lions, they're at home against Ohio State. Villanova, they're at home against UConn. That gives you some idea right there. St. John's at home against Seton Hall. And I told you it was a full slate. DePaul, they're at home against Butler. Miami, the Hurricanes, are at home against Florida State. And as we scroll down, what you're getting is Maryland at home against Purdue. Continuing on, Ohio will visit Eastern Michigan. Toledo will visit Akron. St. Joe's will visit Penn. And just to keep giving you an idea, St. Bonaventure will be at Virginia Commonwealth. Marquette will be at Georgetown. And I told you there was a full slate, folks. So let's see if we're getting to the 4 o'clock games now. The 4 o'clock games, Houston will be at Wichita State. I know that because that's one of my son's favorites. And Merrimack will be at Robert Morris. And now getting out of the 4 o'clock games and traveling into the 5 o'clock games. I told you there, and I'm not even giving you the whole list. Louisville at Duke and Tennessee at Vanderbilt. Stanford at USC. Youngstown State at Wright State. And Sacred Heart, they'll be at St. Francis as we continue down. I told you, a very full slate of games. And anymore, you can really watch any game you want because they're all on everything. And last but not least, BYU will be at number one Gonzaga. And if you stay up late, the Hawaii Rainbows, why, they're taking on UC Santa Barbara. Now, that was the Cedar Sports Corner Report. We're going to take this break. Go to Cedar's, get some great food, enjoy the games, cold beverage, and tell them NCTV 45 sent you. Good luck to all your favorite teams. We'll be right back after this.
This program furnished by Sporting Goods, 23 East Washington Street, Newcastle. Call 724-658-2535.
Penn, Ohio Bottled Water Company. Home, residential, commercial, water coolers. You can contact us Monday through Friday, 8 to 5. PM, we're fast, efficient, and we deliver water. We offer 100% customer satisfaction guarantee. Contact us today at 724-498-4760. This program brought to you by Cummings Landscaping and Design. Brandon Cummins, lower operator. We're back, and a couple things. If you need salted plow, 724-977-3987, call Brandon. He'll help you out. Next up, and I don't know if you were watching, right before we went to break, look how much closer that the line came to us, and they were saying in 20 minutes, and this is 10 minutes. So right now, Pulaski, Neshanic, Union, Mohawk, in through Mahoning Town, starting to get precipitation. And as we can see right at the bottom of the hill here, because Union's only 500 feet away, it is starting right now. So that gives you an idea where we're at. And that was Cleveland radar. This is why we give you two shots of radar, okay, with what we do. Now, as you look at Pittsburgh, you can see, and it's almost a carbon copy, that little pocket getting smaller, moving away, okay, and everything west of Route 18, getting the precipitation. Now we are going to start receiving it, and there's that little pocket. If you're traveling to Pittsburgh, you're in the pocket. If you're going north, if you're going east on I-80, as soon as you get to Clarion, going to start catching the snow. Okay, so just to give you an idea where you're at. And if you're wondering about that temperature, we started out at 26 and it went up to 27. Why? Because in and behind that blue line, you see in the western part of Lawrence County, when you use Cleveland radar, and right above my head, where the 76 is, that is western Lawrence County. That's where the transition line is right now. We picked up a degree. The rain is on its way in. The surface is cold. You could get some freezing. Be extremely careful. Once again, if you need somebody, call Brandon, 724-977-3987, and he'll get you covered. Now, with that, lay some bass. Come and relax and enjoy some dance music with this popular duo. They'll be down here tonight at the Majestic, beautiful Majestic, the lobby, light refreshments served. So make sure you check them out. If you were so inclined, all you can eat, pancake and sausage breakfast, well, dinner, buttermilk pancakes, buckwheat pancakes. This is at the Scottish Rite Cathedral, whole hog sausage, Saturday, the 18th, 3 to 7. Proceeds benefit Children's Dyslexia Center of Western Pennsylvania, the Scottish Rite Cathedral. Adults, $10 at the door. Children under 12, $4. So check that out. I've done that a couple times, and it's pretty doggone good. Excuse me. Now, as we continue on, and I brought up this for you earlier so that you could see these were conditions early this morning as we were showing you. Now that's Mercer Street, there's North Street, and what you're gonna see is as we made the turn to go up the hill, the plows had gotten one side of the street. They hadn't gotten to the other side. Things are getting better. You can see the water right there in front of us. They're getting better, but understand with the temperature and the rain and things coming down, you're going to have some changes. And that gives you a good look at Jefferson Street right there in Newcastle. So catching you up all the way around this morning. If you're looking for a job, PA Career Link, Job and Training Expo, Thursday the 23rd, 10 to 2. NCTV 45 will be there. 10 to 10:15, Military veterans will be granted early entry. General public at 10:15. On-site interviews with employers to fill jobs. Now, moving beyond that, Saturday, the 25th. Okay, and you know, kids don't do this anymore, so I get it that you gotta kind of stress it. It is the Hoyts Creative Play, 10 to 11:30. You have to RSVP by the 24th. That's by Friday. Creative Play is designed to provide youngsters with and innovators with paint, drawing, building, inventing, ages 3 to 7. Classes are free and meet once a month. Parents are welcome to stay, but not required. Call 724-652-2882. The event is free. RSVP by the 24th, as I said. Union Boosters, let's go Scotties. Union Boosters, Night at the Races, helps generate things. Saturday the 15th, Mary Mother of Hope. Make sure that you mark your calendar. They'll have a Chinese auction. Volunteers to help with the event. They need some donations. Keep that in mind as you're going through your time. Mark that on your calendar. Now, let's, if you weren't paying attention this week, we had the Lawrence County commissioners meeting, and look for that to happen again next week. We told you about Lace and Base down here at the Majestic. There are several apartments open down here at the Majestic. They start at $575. St. Vincent de Paul today, 5 o'clock, we'll have mass on, and that way, you know, and you won't have to struggle with when what's going to be on. So, a whole lot as we're pounding forward right here on Newswatch, and hopefully you're having a great morning. Maybe you're nice, safe, warm and dry, and you got that first cup of coffee. And we're going to take this break and head over to Lawrence County 45 weather. Above me is Cleveland radar. Moving in from the west, you have precipitation that is going to be snow. It's going to change to rain. Okay, and over to, well, in the middle is Pittsburgh radar. Okay, and you can see the pocket and that moving in also. Now, what do you have as far as current conditions? 27. We picked up a degree since we started our broadcast. Wind speed south at 5 miles an hour. Barometric pressure 30.18. Dew point 24. And visibility 10 miles. No wind, wind chill 21. And that gives you an idea what we're dealing with. Okay, and that's why I said the surfaces could freeze as you go forward. Now, let's take a look at Lawrence County 45 weather, sponsored by BSB's Bob's Big Shot Wings. Really great stuff. And Tuscany Square, always a favorite. So thanks to them, and let's check out this weather.
BSB. Big Shot Bob's are the wings for me. 50 flavors, make it right, you see. BSB has sandwiches you have to try. Stop in and you'll know why. Every day of the week you see. Call or stop in to BSB. Big Shot Bob's will be your favorite place, just like me.
As we get rolling here to Lawrence County 45 weather. And well, after last night, and we're getting used to it, low 24 and the snow about, how is your Saturday shaping up and your weekend? Well, looking at local radar, you see the snow flurry and ground clutter activity kind of left over. And, well, when you look at the national scene, out there is the leftover precipitation. So what is that meaning for you? Well, here you go. Last night's overnight low 24, as we said, Saturday, icy, 100% wintry mix. Okay. Now, you're going to get up to 40, but be careful if you're out and about early in the morning. Your Saturday night, rain showers, 80% chance. And tonight, you'll find it with an overnight low. Gusty winds, too. I want to make sure that... you know that, an overnight low at 19, so the ice will be back. Sunday, okay, snow will try and cut off, 30% chance of it. Cloudy, high at 22. Okay, so you're not really out of it yet. And then Sunday night, chance of snow showers, cloudy, low at 16, 30% chance of precip. Now things begin to, I use the word get better very loosely. Martin Luther King Day, cloudy, high at 24. Then Monday night, mostly cloudy, low of 16. Tuesday, mostly cloudy and 25. Tuesday night, mostly cloudy, 14. And then Wednesday, mostly sunny with a high of 31. Wednesday night, mostly cloudy, a low of 19. Thursday, partly sunny with a high of 36. Now, that was Lawrence County 45 weather. And we're going to take this break and hear from these great sponsors. Who would like to hear from you? We'll be right back.
Tuscany Square, Rushman, 3470 Wilmington Road, where old world charm meets today's modern conveniences. Go enjoy their spacious, comfortable seating. Their fresh ingredients that go into making every dish, whether it's pizza or that just right entree. Tuscany Square Restaurant, they're here to serve you. Call 724-654-3065.
Vinte Se in Newcastle is a premier winery located on Newcastle's southeast side on Wilson Avenue. Vinte Se open Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. Features a variety of fine wines and also fine food. Vinte Say for the very best.
Well, folks, we're back, and as we get to this radar, and I usually take it off by now, I'm keeping it. And moisture overtaking Lawrence County and the rain overtaking Youngstown. And what do you got coming from the Pittsburgh area? What you're going to see is that pocket. That's getting smaller. You know. And Cleveland shows it overtaking. Pittsburgh shows it a little bit shy. Okay. But that's where we are right now. And as far as the temperature goes, ever since last night's low, we picked up 3 degrees. Just 1 degree as we started our broadcast. So be aware of that as we're moving forward. Now, I'm going to tell you that there's a winter weather advisory that will go today. And keep in mind, it is till 7 p.m. tonight. So, winter weather advisory, that happening tonight as I keep you updated on what's happening here in what I call the greatest castle in the world. Now, Mike Kelly in the news. And Mike telling us he voted no on the impeachment. He voted against both articles on the floor. We have the best economy in years. The president's removed burdensome policies and tax cut have led to low unemployment, higher wages. The unemployment rate 3.5%. Millions of jobs were created for hardworking Americans, and he kept his promises. So that in from Mike Kelly. Now, also, if you get a chance, this Sunday, Faith Abraham will be on TNT. Or TBS. There's a Saga dinner, okay, and she'll be going and see it. So she's invited. The whole story, I really wish I got more on the email, and I didn't. Let's take this break and hear from these great sponsors. We'll be back with a wrap up.
Got a gift from the Newcastle, I tried. The right small town for living. Look
around. Special thanks going out to Town Mall Pizza for sponsorship of this program, located in the Cascade Galleria, Newcastle.
At our law firm, we see you. Come see us at lgkg.com.
These fine businesses provided funding for this program. Gatherings, Town and Country, and On Target.
folks, that's going to do it for this news watch. Remember, as we were showing you the weather outside and streets, that's going to be the flavor of the day. And if anything comes up, we'll let you know about it. Now, one last thing, keep in mind that Saturday, February 8th, it's Douse for the House, the Winter Plunge. It's the 10th annual. Look for that on our Focus NC this week as we strive to keep you informed on what's going on all these great community activities. Make sure that you tell a friend and have a friend tell a friend about NCTV 45. They'll be glad you did. And when they say, oh, I don't watch a lot of TV, you tell them that NCTV 45 is available anytime on your time. Yes, a train that runs on your schedule, why, that's NCTV 45 right here in Newcastle, Lawrence County. Now, the song that I will leave you with as we go through this busy day, and I'll tell you, make sure you're safe out there. Here you go. A little on the radio with Donna Summer. Now, make sure that you tell a friend and have a friend tell a friend about NCTV 45. They'll be glad you did. When they say, I don't watch a lot of TV, you tell them we're available anytime on your time. He has a train that runs on your schedule. That's NCTV 45 right here in Newcastle, Lawrence County. Make sure you get that second cup of coffee, hot chocolate, whatever you're drinking, and have a super day in what I call the greatest castle in the world, in the County of Lawrence. Now, Donna Summer will take us out, and the snow is coming down. Make sure you stay safe, warm, and dry, and keep an ear out to NCTV 45, available anytime on your time. Have a great Saturday, everybody. Never told the soldiers how